the railway station is the opening of the movie Blood Rain. This is basically a transport of people to Auschwitz. They're getting into the concentration camp sent off by the Nazis, the commandant, Michael Paré. And this train gets attacked by the rebels, by the partisans, leaded by Nathaniel, who is played by Brendan Fletcher.
I kind of laughed and was like, well, I mean, I'm only like 5'4", and so like, you know, what kind of character is this? Like, is he smart, or like, how do I approach this? Am I just super intense? Is that how I'm the leader?
And by a surprising attack, Blood Rain appears and kicks some serious ass here.
We're trying to stop them, and we come across Rain, who is single-handedly cutting down the men. We meet up with her and convince her to join our forces to take down the Nazis and prevent them from eventually getting to Berlin without getting too much of the plot away, because you should watch the movie.
Why isn't this train moving? Where's your second?
Character I'm playing is called Rain. She had no choice in the matter. She was born half vampire, so I'm sure she has issues with that.
In her other movies, Skinwalkers, Elektra, and so on, I think she showed that she can kick high kicks and everything because she was a ballerina before. So I think as an action hero, she comes across really strong.
All the characters in the movie are just kind of a mirror of where she's at in her life, the monsters that Rain carries herself.
She trained with Larry Lamb, the fight choreographer, and with Anthony, the stunt coordinator, and it shows that she got better and better. And of course, the training with Larry is great. He did Sucker Punch, he did 300, he did iRobot, A-Team, and so on. And I think that he as a fight choreographer is gold. So the same with the stunt coordinator, Anthony, who did Blood Diamond, but also Tunnel Rats and Darfur, my movies.
Natasha,
come here, quick blocking.
We don't want to lose the daylight again. So you come in with the swords, with your two swords. Whack! Bam! Two swords down, right? He wants to hit you again. Catch it. Whack! But now, no. Now, keep it in your hand, like this. Hold it up, both hands, hold it up. So, he moves back. You go here, you move forward, he moves back, because he has the advantage now. Wait. You stop here, boom, he pulls out the knife. The guy comes from behind, boom. Yeah, wait. Yeah, let's make this short and bloody, right? You step into him, but the guy behind you came already in, boom.
sprays his face, right? She turns, hits the guy with the bar, right? Now she wants to finish him up. She moves forward, but the guy shoots. So it sprays in his face, it distracts him quick. She turns backwards, hits the guy, right? So the guy is knocked out on the ground. Now he attacks with the knife, wham! He goes on his knees, whack, impaling. Yeah. So work on the timing, Larry, but this is the work. And then maybe we shoot first this way, right? If we need the impaling from front.
And who, shall I say, has the honor of besting me today?
Honor? The last thing this is about is honor. My apologies, but the locals are finishing up outside. So let's just make this short and bloody.
Michael Paré, I think I shot now almost 10 movies with. My first American movie, Sanctimony. Then Blackwoods, Heart of America, he's in. Then he was in Far Cry, he was in Impostor. In Seed, he played the cop. Now here in Blood Rain 3, he was also in Blood Rain 1 and in Blood Rain 2. In the last few years, I think he got better and better and better, and he proved that, especially in his hilarious Postal appearance.
Trying to get a dollar out of 15 cents.
Standing hey, on yo, the corner, pal. Trying to steal come here, help me out with a few bucks.
I don't have any money.
Come on, I'm serious, come over here. I need a few bucks to get a bus to go see my kids.
I don't have any money.
Hey, come here, I want a joke. Come here. Get the fuck out of here. I'm sick and tired of people like you, you know? You got a good job, you got a big car, you got everything and I got nothing. Well, fuck you and fuck everybody who even looks like you. Get the fuck out of here.
So he's really my best friend if it comes down to actors. I work a long time with him and I really like him from the beginning of his career on. And if you need a cop or an agent or whatever, he's the perfect actor.
I get killed by Blood Rain, and then she is shot, so she needs a little energy boost, so she bites me and turns me into a vampire. But when she's shot, her blood hits my face and some lands in my mouth, and that turns me into a Damphir. Now, a Damphir is a daywalker, a vampire who can go out in the sun. So this becomes a brilliant idea of Clint Howard, who plays the doctor, to turn a whole army of Nazi soldiers into Damphir daywalkers.
What are you doing? No! That is for the Führer!
Heil Hitler.
Oh no!
I had him in House of the Dead, I had him in Heart of America. And I'm very happy to work with him again. And he's, I think, a great actor. And because he looks so crazy or whatever, it's not easy to find a part for him. But if you have an over-the-top character like we with Dr. Mengele, I think he's absolutely perfect.
I love the spirit of horror movies. And this being, you know, a vampire Nazi movie, it's a little like Mexican food. You know, it's spicy. It tastes really good. It's not something you want to eat all the time. I mean, I myself personally don't like to watch horror movies all the time, but occasionally it's fun to have a meal of a horror film.
Doctor? Oh my God.
I certainly hope not. There are a plethora of useless deities to worship, Lieutenant. If you're so inclined, this is certainly not one of them.
Is that a vampire?